Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temi Tayo. I'm a Christian content creator, and I'm here once again to share from the daily Open Heavens daily devotional compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. And the reason I'm sharing from this particular Christian book is because the Lord instructed me to do so as I prepare to enter into the year 2020. So this is my fourth year of sharing, and that's why we call this season four. And all those videos from 2020 are all loaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Agedo. I will encourage you to visit my channel, not only to view those old Open Heavens videos, which are a great study guide and teaching guide, but also, and most importantly, to view the Open Heavens for the current day. And I know that will bless you immensely. And while you're on my channel, please don't forget to subscribe, and the Lord bless you as you do. Pastor Adeboye led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back, when I was an undergraduate in the University of Lagos, Nigeria, in West Africa. And Pastor gives you a few scriptures from the Bible and a memory verse, and that helps you to understand the body of the text. Praise God. And today is Monday, October the 9th. I hope you had a good weekend. Now, we've been studying on the way. Okay, so we talked about the way out, and today we're going to be talking about the way forward. And Jesus Christ is the way forward, he's the way out, and he's the way. Praise God. So we're going to be looking at Luke chapter 5 verses 1 to 7. Luke chapter 5 verses 1 to 7, and I'm going to be reading from the traditional King James version. Don't forget, today's title is the way forward. Praise God. Yesterday we talked about the way out, so I encourage you to view those videos because there's great teaching in them. And thus goes the reading of God's word. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake Gennesaret, and saw two ships standing by the lake, but the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would trust out a little from land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now, when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught. And Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down thy net. And when they had done this, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net brake. And they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both ships, so that they began to sink. Praise God. The Lord is a miracle working God. He works miracles, and he does signs and wonders in all the earth, you know. So he's a miracle working God. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, anything can happen. There's liberty, there's freedom, there's emancipation from bondage. And that's exactly what happened. So the way forward, it seems to indicate that somebody has come to a standstill. And they don't know what to do next. God is saying to us the way forward, which is what happened to the children of Israel when they got to the Red Sea. You know, they stood because now Moses, the Egyptians were coming from behind them, and before them was the Red Sea. And, you know, Moses said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. And God said, no, tell the people to go forward. Praise God. It's a Rhema word, the way forward. And the way forward is the word of God. In the word of God, and Jesus Christ is the word of God made flesh. And so that's what happened to Peter. You know, he had come to a stage where, you know, he's a professional fisherman. He had gone out to fish at the right time. He had done everything right. And still nothing was working. He had done everything that he knew to do, and there was nothing working. And it seemed he had come to the end of the road. Now, as I read this, I remembered, you know, during COVID, there was a particular man in London, around where I live, and he had been in business for 40 years. And when COVID hit, there was no way. So he closed down his shop. He closed down his business that he had been running for 40 years. That was the end. But you see, there's always God. Jesus Christ is the way forward. He's not only the way, he's also the way out and the way forward. Praise God. And so that's what happened to Peter. He toiled. He had struggled all night. He had been struggling, doing this thing. He knew what he was doing, but it was not yielding the kind of results. And he just thought, "I'm packing it up. I've had enough. You know, I'm done." And he, Jesus Christ offered to use his boat. He allowed Jesus Christ. He was washing his net. You know, they talked about Jesus Christ that, you know, it was a miracle. He wasn't even concerned. He was just washing his net. And Jesus Christ gave him instruction. And he said, "We have toiled all night and caught nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, when you move on God's word, did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? If Mary and Martha, if Martha had not arranged for the stone to be rolled away, she would not have seen the glory of God. And if Simon, if he didn't act on God's word, he said, we've told all night, nevertheless, at your word." So always move at the instance of God's word. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. If the servants at the wedding in Cana of Galilee, if they do not fill the water pots with water according to the word of the woman of God, they would not have seen the glory of God. But Peter was wise. So God will give you a word. It may not make sense. If the children of God did not go forward, they would have perished at the Red Sea. So nevertheless, and when he did, God told him to cast his nets. He cast his nets, and yet he still saw that miracle. Praise God. Jesus Christ is the way forward. And the memory verse is taken from, I love this memory verse. It says that Proverbs 4:18 says that, but the path, Proverbs 4:18, it says, but the path of the just is as the shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day. But the path of the just is as the shining light that shineth more and more, or brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. So it shines more and more and more and more. You know, we get better and better and better. So, but you see, it's very, very clear. It says the path of the just. Another translation says, the Amplified Classic Translation, it says the uncompromisingly just and righteous. So when it's talking about our path shining brighter and brighter, it's not talking to those who are not born again. It's talking to those who have accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. The just, the uncompromisingly just and uncompromisingly righteous. In fact, it's not even talking to all Christians. Is talking to those who have fallen Jesus Christ in truth and in spirit. Our path is as a shining light that gets brighter and brighter onto the perfect day, from one level of glory to another. Pastor says that Jesus is the way forward, full stop. Jesus is the way, full stop. And Jesus Christ is the word of God made flesh. So the word of God is the way forward, full stop. In Luke 5, 1 to 7, Peter had fished all night but caught nothing. He wasn't lazy, but he was still considered a failure. When Jesus stepped into his boat, however, all of a sudden there was a way forward. No, because Jesus Christ is light. So you might have seen darkness, and suddenly he causes his light. That light shines in darkness, and darkness cannot comprehend it. So suddenly there's a way out. There's a way forward. You just see the word of God just enlightens. Thou shalt enlighten my darkness, the Bible says. And suddenly there was a way forward. Just like Peter, many people find themselves going round in circles. When Jesus steps into your boat, your forward motion will become accelerated. Amen. Amen. You see, so like Peter, many people have found themselves going round and round in circles, doing the same thing over and over again. No result. They are struggling. They're struggling. That's the spirit of Kadesh Barnea. You know, children of Israel, until God said, "You have gone around this mountain too long. You know, turn eastward." And when Jesus steps into your boat, your forward, when he comes in, everything, there's divine acceleration. Praise God. One of my sons, pastor says, came to me and said, "Daddy, I've been on one spot for more than 12 years. I've applied to an organization now and I've been scheduled for an interview, so I need prayers to succeed." I was about to pray for him when he said, "No, don't pray. Just say a word." So I said, "Go and the interview will go well." He said amen and left. He returned the following day excited. "Daddy, I prepared for that interview like no man's business. And when I got there, they only asked me three questions. What is your name? What position did you apply for? And when can you start?" I told them that I will start tomorrow. I congratulated him and said, and he said, "No, speak another word." And I did. And the following day, he came again trembling. "Daddy, I got a new place of work and was told that their managing director just resigned. And then they asked me to become the new managing director." And again, he asked me to speak another word, so I did. And the following day, he was back. This time, he was almost speechless. Daddy, they discovered that their managing director resigned because their competitor offered him double the salary they were paying. And since they don't want me to leave, they doubled my salary. I congratulated him again. And he said, no, speak another word. And this time I said jokingly, do you want to take the company from, do you want to take the company over from the owners? Praise God. Now, this is a testimony. I've experienced, you know, similar things. And when you're a child of God, you see miracles like this. This is a miracle. This is the intervention of God in the life of a man. And you see, this guy needed a miracle because, you see, he said, I've been on one spot for more than 12 years. You know, spirit of Kadesh Barnea, where a person goes round and round, or there's a stagnation. There seems to be no progress, you know. He seems to have gotten to that state where he doesn't know what next to do. You know, his spirit of Kadesh Barnea. And he went to meet his pastor. Now, the Bible says that God confirms the word. That's why God put his servants there. His servants are meant to help his children. That's why God gives you a pastor. You must have a pastor. You must have a shepherd over your life, because there are some problems that you will have that you will need the intervention of your pastor. God put him there for that purpose. Okay. So the Bible says that God confirms the word of his servant and performs all the counsel of his messenger. When the sheep has a problem, he needs intervention of the shepherd. That is the purpose of the shepherd. The manifestation of the Spirit has been given to him for the profiting of the church. Amen. And so he went to meet the pastor and said, look, daddy, I've been going through this, you know, and, you know, he was about to pray. And he said, no, daddy, don't pray. Just speak a word. I'm going for an interview. And daddy spoke a word. His pastor spoke a word over him. God will always confirm the word of his servant and his maid servant that he has sent to shepherd his flock. And then he saw a miracle. He came back again and said, you know, that they had given him the job. They didn't even interview him. And then the next thing, he went the next day. He asked daddy to speak another word. Daddy spoke another word. By the time he went, they made him managing director. Then he asked daddy to speak another word again. And he received another miracle. Because God confirms the word of his servant. The Bible says that, believe the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. It's the Bible that says it. Believe the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe his prophet, so shall you prosper. Sometimes it may not even be just the pastor. It can be your cell leader. Because God follows authority. There's authority. We must never break rank. Amen. So, and God will always confirm the word of his servants and perform the counsel of his messengers. If you believe the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe his prophet, so shall ye prosper. And that's exactly what happened. So it's the same word. The same God walking through Peter walks through the shepherd, through the pastor. Pastor says, when I was a lecturer in the University of Lagos, I had a driver. But then somehow, by the middle of the month, I would have become so broke that I would be borrowing money to fuel the car from the same driver whose salary I was paying. I was being relatively well paid, but somehow I wasn't moving forward in life. I then met Christ and everything turned around. Not because of any brilliance on my part, but rather simply because I gave my life to Christ and began to live holy. And this can be your story too if you do the same. Praise God. So you see, salvation, you know, salvation changes things. Salvation is where you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. The Egyptians that you saw before, you will see them no more forever. Things change. The struggle ends because Jesus Christ is now the head of your life. He's now your Lord. And so some of the struggles that you are going through are unnecessary. It's because you have not accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. You have not met the Christ. And sometimes you can be in church for 50 years and still not have met the Christ until you become born again. So you must be born again. You must give your heart to Christ and side with his party. Declare him as Lord over your life, as master over your life. And when you do that, there's a translation from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God's dear son, because it's the only way out from that generational thing, that pattern that you have seen in your generations, out of that problem that is in your home. Your marriage is not working, your job is not working, your business is not working, nothing is working. You are just filled, you are suffering, you are struggling. Even people in the world look at you and they're wondering. You need to give your heart to Christ and live holy. And that's exactly, I have the same testimony too. I have the same testimony. From the time I gave my life to Christ, the addiction to cigarette smoking ended and many other things stopped. Jesus Christ is the way forward. How long will you halt between two opinions? If God be God, follow him, and if Baal be Baal, follow him. Why halt here between two opinions? Jesus Christ is the way forward. When you have try him and see, say, oh, test and see that the Lord is good. Amen. And the key point here is that with Jesus in your boat, success is guaranteed. Don't worry. If you are born again, your path is as a shining light that shines brighter and brighter onto the perfect day. But the way of the wicked is as darkness. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is the way forward. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you because there is no other name given under heaven amongst men by which we can be saved. Jesus Christ is the way. He's the truth. He's the way out and he's the way forward. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for saving our souls. Thank you for washing us with your blood. Thank you for dying for us on the cross of Calvary. Thank you for giving us the gift of your Holy Spirit. Father, let every yoke be destroyed because of the anointing. The Bible says that you have broken the gates of brass and you have cut asunder the bars of iron. Today, have mercy on every one of us according to your loving kindness and according unto the multitude of your tender mercies, and help us to lay aside the sins that so easily beset us, so that you can work wonders in our life and move us to the next level. Thank you, Heavenly Father. We give you praise because you do exceedingly abundantly above that which we can ask or think, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Thank you so much for taking time to listen to me. I hope this blessed you. And while you're on my channel, very important, don't forget to subscribe. That really helps my channel a lot, and I give you permission to share this video freely. God bless you. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. My name again is Sister Temitayo, and the Lord bless you. Have a nice day.